Praise the Lord. Once again, welcome to a message on the book of John, chapter 14. This day, Sunday, we would like to welcome you for a time of message that I would like to share with you. And please turn with me to book of John, chapter 14, verse number 1-6. Do not let your heart be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I am going to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be there where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I am the way, the truth, and life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really know me, you know my Father as well. From now on, you know him and have seen him. We see here that Jesus made a statement that is no one else has ever made. And in one word, he makes two important statements. And these are the statements, I am the way, the truth, and life. Verse 6. I am the way, the truth, and the life. And the second statement is, no one goes to the Father or comes to the Father except through me. Christ says, without me, you cannot approach God. In simple language, you want to meet God, you want to be in the presence of God, you have to go through me. And I am the way through which you can reach God. That's what he says. And this prompted two of his disciples, Thomas and Philip, to ask questions. Like when he says, I'm going, you know the way. So Thomas says, where are you going? We don't know the way. And Jesus says that I am the way, the truth, and life. And no one comes to the Father except through me. And later on, Philip says, Lord, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. Now you see, Jesus says, show us the Father, and that will, Philip says, show us the Father, and that will be enough for me. And Jesus answered and said to Philip, don't you know me, Philip? Even after I have been among you such a long time, anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show me the Father? Don't you believe that I am in Father and that the Father is in me? You see, that he made it very clear that God and he were one. Okay? Now we are going to look at little more closely at the phrases and the statements that Christ made. One of the among the statement is, I am the way, the truth, and life. So we are going to primarily look at this statement, I am the way, the truth, and life. And we are going to see that Christ is the way. The first phrase, I am the way. How is Jesus the only way to God? Well, Jesus clearly claims that he is the only way. When we look at the world and the religions of the world, there were many great philosophers, great men who tried to establish and who have established religions like Siddhartha Gautam Buddha, Buddhism, Jainism, and then Islam by Muhammad. Then we have the Confucius establishing the Confucianism. But none of these made a statement about themselves that they are the way to God. They said, these are the light through which you can go. These are the paths, noble paths he talked about. But that's Buddha. But Jesus said, I am. Today we find the grave or the memorial places of all these men who founded the world religions all over. Muhammad's tomb is found. Confucius is there. But Christ made this statement and his grave is empty. He rose from the dead. The blessed hope of the church is the resurrection, that he rose. They died and they are buried and they are there in their grave or in their tomb. But Jesus rose. And Jesus made this emphatic statement, declaring, I am the way. He is the only way. And Peter, in the book of Acts, chapter 4, verse 12, says, let's look at it. Just turn with me to the book of Acts, chapter 4, verse 12. Here he says, salvation is found in no one else, for there is no other name under the heaven given to men by which we must be saved. So Peter makes it very clear that salvation is found only through Jesus Christ. There's no other name given under the heaven by which you and I can be saved. So Jesus is the way to God. Jesus Christ is the way through which we can reach God, have fellowship with God. Then maybe we may understand that Christ made a statement which was incorrect, or maybe it was incorrect politically on his day. But he made that statement and the Pharisees opposed. But we'll look at it little later. But Jesus says how he is the way to the Father. Let's look at it again. Verse 9 says that anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. Don't you? Verse 10 says of John chapter 14, verse 10, don't you believe that I am in the Father and that the Father is in me? What a statement. So he's declaring himself to be God himself. And then in John chapter 1, shall we turn to the John chapter 1, verse 18, what does it say? It's a beautiful words that we see, John 1, 18. It says, no one has ever seen God, but God the one and only who is at the Father's side has made him known. No one has seen God, but God, the one and only who was at the side of the Father, has made God known. Another version says, God the Son, who was in the bosom of the Father, has made God known. So God the Son was in the bosom of the Father. He was in the right in the lap beside Father, he's sitting on the throne. He is God. Another place, when we look at the deity of Christ, we see that Christ said, is the Son of God. And right here in the book of John, chapter 1, verse 1. Who is Christ? Look at the declaration by the Apostle John, the writer of the Gospel. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So, in the beginning was the Word, the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. And then in verse 14, let's read John chapter 1 verse 14. What does it say? The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. So Jesus says, I am the way. And he proves it and makes it clear that Jesus is the way. Now, how is he the way? He has opened the way for us. In the book of Hebrews, we look, he opened the way for us to reach Father. Shall we turn to the book of Hebrews, chapter 10? Hebrews chapter 10. And verse number 19 and 20, I want to read for you. Verse 19 and 20. Therefore, brothers, since we have confidence to enter the most holy place by the blood of Jesus, by a new and a living way, opened for us through the curtain that is his body. New and holy way. Christ is the way. The writer of the Hebrews declares it and says that Christ is the new and living way through whom we can enter into the holy place. Now, if you look at the Old Testament worship, and when you look at the Old Testament, we understand that the temple had two parts, the holy place and the holy of holies. There, the two places of these two places were separated by a curtain. And in the holies of holies, only the high priest could go only once in a year to minister on the day of atonement. Everyone was not able to go. But here the writer of Hebrews says that the new way through the curtain of his body, Christ, he has opened the way for us. And this is a new way. We can approach God straight and clearly. Also, let's look at again book of Hebrews. I'll be referring to Hebrews a number of times. Chapter 2. Hebrews chapter 2, verse 17 and 18. So much of truth in the Word of God. Here it says, for this reason he had to be made like his brothers in every way, in order that he might become a merciful and faithful high priest in service to God, and that he might make atonement for the sins of the people, because he himself suffered when he was tempted, he is able to help those who are being tempted. You see, Christ offered himself to open the door for us to be in the presence of God. Then in 1 John, it says that he intercedes for us. He prays for you and for me. And 1 John chapter 2, verse 1. Let's look at it. 1 John chapter 2. My dear children, I write this to you so that ye will not sin. But if anybody does sin, we have one who speaks to the Father in our defense, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. You see, he's advocating, he's praying, he talks to the Father on your behalf, on my behalf, that Father, I died for this man. Please forgive his sins. That's what it is. And then he sits at the right hand of God the Father. God the Father had exalted him to his right hand. And he sits there praying for you, interceding for you and me. And 1 Timothy 2, 5 says, there is only one mediator between God and man, the man Jesus Christ. He is the only one mediator. He is the mediator who mediates between God and man, between you and me, to take us in the presence of God. Who forever lives to intercede for us. He is merciful and lives forever and ever to intercede for you and for me, to pray for you and for me. Hebrews chapter 7 verse 24 and 25 says that he lives forever to pray for you and for me. The virtue by him, we need to understand, by his life, by his death on the cross, and now in the service to God in heaven, he is the way, the only way we can go to God. This is what it is. We need to understand Jesus is the way. I will continue to teach on the other two statements. He says, I am the truth and the life. In the next session, and I hope and I pray that you have benefited from this word that God has put in my heart to teach and share in this Bible study message. And we will have a wonderful time in the presence of God the next time we meet. Thank you. God bless you.